This is a drafting exercise where you will have to draft an abstract for this patent specification. You can see it's a granted patent by the US Patent Office. Obviously, I know that you will have access to it. You can just search it online and get it. But the point is to draft an abstract. I mean, in fact, we have hid the abstract portion. We have removed it, and we have just put in the three words, draft an abstract. Now, the patent is a simple one, and it's quite an interesting one too. As you read it, you will understand it pertains to a particular technology that is commonly around us in all the places. You would read it and you will understand that this is something which most of us use probably on a day-to-day basis. So you would ideally read this. The exercise that requires to be done here, as I mentioned, is to draft an abstract. Now, how do you draft an abstract? Section 10 of the Patents Act clearly states that the complete specification should have an abstract. Now, you get that from Section 10.4 D. Every complete specification shall be accompanied by an abstract to provide technical information on the invention. Okay, now that actually gives you an insight on what the abstract does. The abstract provides technical information on the invention. Provided that the controller may amend the abstract for providing better information to third parties. That's a power the controller has. And if the applicant mentions biological material, there are some details on what needs to be done. So this is the relevant portion of the Act, which says the abstract has to provide technical information of the invention. Again, as we saw in the case of the title, there is nothing with regard to how long the abstract should be or how the way in which the abstract should be presented. You will find that in the corresponding rules. Now, I want you to take the corresponding rule, which we had already mentioned in the context of the title. Okay, Rule 13 deals with specifications. And Rule 13, the abstract, you will find it in 7B. 7A, 7B, yes. Here you will find that one point you need to note here is that 7B was recently amended by the Patents Amendment Rules of 2016. So this isn't what you see now in Section 7B is an amended provision. The abstract shall contain a concise summary of the matter contained in the specification. So, one thing, point number one, it should contain a concise summary of what is contained in the specification, and the summary shall indicate clearly the technical field to which the invention belongs. Two, it should cover or it should indicate the technical field. The technical development of the invention as compared to the existing knowledge, that's a requirement number three. It should describe the technical advancement of the invention compared to the prior art, and principal use of the invention, that's point number four, excluding any speculative use, and wherever necessary, the abstract should contain a chemical formula with characteristics which characterizes the invention. That's additional point five. So 5 points need to get into your abstract. First, it should be a concise summary of the matter contained in the specification. The summary should clearly indicate the technical field. That's point number two. The technical advancement of the invention over prior art should come in your abstract. That's point number three. The principal use, excluding speculative use, should come out. That's point number four. And finally, if your invention pertains to chemical substance, then you should have the chemical formula. Now, rule 7C tells us that this is the function of the abstract. The structure of the abstract is in rule 13.7C. The abstract may not contain more than 150 words. Now, what I want you to do, now that you have this problem before you, I want you to read this and generate an abstract. Now, and in the process, you will, now that I've told you what are things that needs to get into the abstract and what are the structural limitations, which is it cannot be more than 150 words. Now, in the light of this, I want you to generate or try this exercise of drafting an abstract.